Often landlords and investors inquire about the best way to save money on gas and electricity bills when it comes to heating up a HMO like this one here, which is a six-bedroom HMO in the area of Derby. Well, today we're going to talk a little bit about what we feel is the best device to save you, landlord, and investors money with regards to heating up the homes of your lovely tenants. We'll talk about it in detail in just a second. So this device is called the thermostat, which I'll put a link on the video below so you can actually go to the website directly and find out prices, availability, and range of devices that comes with this particular brand. It's called the thermostat. So it's a very simple device to use. All tenants, anybody could really use it. It has a plus and minus on each end. The plus and minus on the left hand side dictates the time. It works on a countdown clock, and if I was to currently an hour and 52 minutes, it just changed to from 53 to 52. If I was good to go down, you can see that it's actually coming off completely. So if I come home, if I'm a tenant and I come home and it's a bit chilly, it's a bit cold, then I can just press the plus button here up to about 2 hours. Although you can program the thermostats to go up to 3 hours maximum. But that is the key part of this device. It allows or restricts the time that the house is heat up or the boiler is actually working up to a maximum of 3 hours. In this particular case, with this current setup, is 2 hours. You can see here the battery, time remaining, current time of the day, the room temperature, and obviously it's heating out the radiators. The plus and minus to your right, it dictates the temperature. So it's very simple. You go up and down, whatever desired temperature you want to, or up if you want it a little bit more warm and cozy. Now, the device, it's talking to the boiler wirelessly. You can see that there. There are two devices that you've got, a wired one, you got a battery operated one. I would advise you, if possible, pending funding and construction of the building, to go for the wire device. Therefore, you will not need a reservoir like this one, which holds the battery. You'll need an Allen key there to open and change the batteries. I'll talk about one flaw that I have found about this device, if anything, because it's brilliant, brilliant, brilliant. It's the only heating device that you should be purchasing and providing to your tenants, particularly on a HMO, house of multiple occupancy. So just a little bit more detail, this button here in the middle, it tells you that it is a preset setting for an hour at 5:45 in the morning, and a further one for an hour at 5:30 in the afternoon. Currently 6:20, and we just press that and it goes away. So yeah, this is the thermostat. We put a user guide there to make tenants aware how to use it. A brilliant, brilliant little device to get you to save some money and to keep your tenants nice and warm. Just a little quick, not so thoughtful thing. If anybody wants to change batteries, tenants, they tend to be a little bit more not too flexible when it comes to getting things done and getting repairs done. The only flaw that I will find in this device is right here. You need an Allen key to replace the batteries. Tenants will tend to possibly force it. But, you know, you can explain to your tenants at the time of the check-in that they just need an Allen key, or leave an Allen key on the top here and put a note. If you need a battery, use the Allen key. So that's it. That's your thermostat. Hope this was helpful. Have a good day.